Okay, everyone, so let's get back into the meditation again. And as always, try to get into this nice routine. We follow a certain procedure just to make sure that you cover all your bases, as they say, and kind of go in the right direction. Sometimes you can go through these procedures very fast. Other times it takes a long time, depending on where your mind is at, the state of your mind. But always go through them at least quickly, so that you have assured that you are on the right track. Yeah? And then you can kind of check on yourself to make sure your mind is in the right space and all of this. And I thought for this evening we can do a little bit of a guided death meditation. It was suggested by someone. And just to give you some idea how to think about this. All of these things are very personal and individual, and you can do it whatever way seems suitable for you. This is just to give you some idea of how it can be done. And the idea really here is just to give you a foundation for the breath meditation. Something that can take you deeper down the track. It's like a preliminary thing. And that is what is meant to be in this particular case. But before we do that, always settle down, first of all, bring up a degree of mindfulness, because without that, any kind of meditation is very difficult. Please remember this nice simile of being a passenger on the train. Your job is just to be present, or not even that. Your job is just to sit there and allow things to happen, not to drive this process. And when you get this right, you are like just resting rather than meditating, just chilling out and just having a good time rather than doing anything. Once you get into that frame of mind, it tends to become very pleasant. The reason for meditation not being pleasant usually is doing too much. This is about rest time, not about doing time. This is about sitting in your armchair, allowing the world to flow, not deliberately trying to see anything here. Forget about the breath. If the breath is there, fine. If it's not there, that is also okay here. Now is just the time to relax. Okay, then when your mindfulness is reasonably clear, you are ready to do any kind of meditation, really. And so let's try just a very gentle death contemplation. If you don't feel comfortable with it, please don't do it. Just carry on as you normally do. But if you are at ease with these things, then you can just very gently follow my suggestions. And so to start out, just imagine yourself on your deathbed. And remember, in a sense, we are always on our deathbed because we don't know when it's going to happen. So make it real in this way. Don't kind of make it an imaginary thing, but actually, you really are on your deathbed. You're lying on your back in a room. It's a room without any kind of features. The walls are white. There is no window. The door is closed. There's nothing of interest in this room. You're lying on a bed with some white linen. You're wearing some sort of white hospital garment or whatever it is. And you're lying on your back, looking at the ceiling. It's a white ceiling. There's nothing of interest in this room. You have spoken your farewells to all the people in your life. And you know that the time of death is approaching very fast. Maybe you have a few hours left. You will not be meeting anyone between now and the time of your death. You will just be lying on the back, on your back in this room, just waiting until the time arrives. What does that feel like? And just make a mental note of that feeling, and we can come back to that later on, how to use that feeling for your later contemplation. But for now, just carry on with this contemplation exercise, and you know that you're getting closer and closer to the time of your death. You will just be lying on this bed. This is all that's going to happen from now until you get there. No one is going to come and visit you. This is the end of your life. So now you start to realize that you're going to have to give up everything in this world. And the most obvious things that you're going to have to give up are all your possessions, including your house, including all the things that are most dear to you. Everything has to go. So give these things up. Loosen those attachments. And sort of mentally abandon these things. And your final moments are coming closer and closer. And you recognize that there is much more to be abandoned and given up. And one of the most important things to give up is all the relationships in your life, all the people that are close to you, and anyone at all in this world. Everyone is going to have to go. Here on the journey is a solitary one. You're going to have to go this on your own. No one can come with you. So say goodbye to everyone in your life, in your mind's eye. Now is the time to bid them farewell, to wish them well, and to travel on in solitude. And you realize as you're getting closer and closer to your final moments that there's even more that you have to abandon. So much of who we take ourselves to be, so much of our identity, so much of our ego is tied up with this world. Our education, our nationality, our reputation in the world, our status in society, our position in the family, whatever it is, it all relates to things in this world. All of this, it becomes meaningless now. Even your gender becomes meaningless at this point. And so abandon all of these social markers. Now all of these things have to be left behind. And you kind of carry on with a beautiful sense of emptiness instead. Can you feel that emptiness inside her when you abandon all of these self markers for who you think you are? It's beautiful to let go of the ego and the sense of self. It leads to a peaceful, quiet, empty feeling within her that actually is very delightful. You start to understand the burden of the ego in the world. And now you are getting very, very close to your death, the final moments in this life. And you realize that one of the last things you have to let go of is your physical body. So see if you can find a sense of release from the physical body. Let go of this thing of flesh that you've been carrying around, this heavy burden for so many years. And see if you can feel the lightness of just being with your mind and releasing yourself from the physical body. You feel that lightness of the mind, as if so many burdens in life have been let go of. And all that really remains is this mind that is beautifully empty. There's nothing much going on at all. All you are carrying with you into the future are the good qualities you have built up in this life, the goodness of your heart, and the empty feeling in the mind. And there comes a point in this process, we are no longer sure whether you are dead or alive. you realize that the distinction between death and life actually is very artificial. You're just carrying on, letting go of burdens, and you're still there, moving forward, moving into something interesting and exciting. You're feeling light, untroubled, peaceful, and empty inside, carrying your good qualities with you. And as you carry on in this way, it is becoming very clear that you are now left your whole life behind. And all you feel is a sense of lightness and emptiness, a sense of beauty, carrying all of these good qualities with you. And you start to wonder why you were ever afraid of this process of dying. It is a beautiful process. It's a process of letting go. It's a process of taking the good qualities with you and leaving the difficult things behind. And you recognize that what has made this delightful process possible is all the good spiritual friends in your life, all the people in the world who have made this possible for you. And you start to feel this immense sense of gratitude. All this wonderful process that could only happen because of all of these other people in your life. What a wonderful thing it is to have had such friends. You feel a sense of gratitude for all those people gradually spreading out to the whole world. And now, if you like, you can come back again to your ordinary meditation, whatever that might be. Just relax, just enjoy. And if the breath is there, you can follow the breath if you like. See now to carry on with the ordinary way and see if it makes a difference to you. But remember to be at ease, not to control, allow things to be as you have done through this contemplation we've just been through. again coming very close to the end, and just take a few moments just to again evaluate your progress, trying to understand the causality in meditation here. Okay, so let's have a short break.